Hello, Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to give the exposition of the marriage of the son. And in previous videos, I have explained that unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot preach gospel, and Christ you receive by the grace of our Father. Then again, no son of man, no son of God. So the people in Israel, the so-called the chosen people, they are the demonstration nation of the world. And to teach us the moral laws, they give their sacrifices, and we should appreciate that. Now these people have suffered Holocaust because they loved darkness to light. If they knew gospel, if they preached gospel to wherever they went to live, then they would have been the sons of man with Christ in their hearts, and they would have created a community that will flourish. They would love them, and they love them also, mutual love, which is called agape. Agape is the love above the your own tribal love or eros. So Jesus was born of the Virgin of Judah tribe by the power of our Mother Holy Spirit, who spoke to Mary the will of our Father. So it's always the Holy Spirit, the tongue that speaks. Same in Jesus, we had the daughter, anointed daughter of the Holy Spirit. So when Christ Jesus was preaching gospel, then he was acting as the anointed daughter of Holy Spirit, preaching gospel of his word. And those people who understood the gospel, they had the spirit of man, and we were the daughter with small d. He was the daughter with capital D, we were daughters with the small d. So, as you know, you have in a family daughters, and when the elder daughter gets married, she goes to her parental, our in-laws' house. And when she goes there, then she knows all the things of the in-laws. So, in this case, in our spiritual one, it applies just the opposite. Our anointed daughter with capital D, she came from our parental home, which is God. She came, this word is the home of the in-laws. We have been sent into this home. And our anointed daughter, because she came from our parental home, God, she knows the ins and outs of our Father's home. You know, Father's home is so vast, you know, that nobody has ever been able to understand the mysteries of God. Not even Christ Jesus or Nanak or anyone. So all are giving glimpses of our Father. Thus, our Father protects us whilst our Mother feeds us with His Word. Unless a person has Holy Spirit, which is common sense, he cannot enjoy the living bread provided by our Mother Holy Spirit, which is extraordinary sense that the apostles possessed after being paid their wage of Holy Spirit by our Father. And our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus acted as a foreman who trained his Father's workers, or his laborers for the vineyard of God. So this is the situation that the apostles, when they received the Holy Spirit of God as their wage at the Pentecost, then they became the twin brethren of Christ Jesus. They also then had the Christ, they also became Christ with capital C. We are Christ with small c, because we are the spirit of man and they had the spirit of God. Among those 12 who received their wage, Peter was once born. Once born means that he did not have the knowledge of God. So that's why he was keeping quiet. He would not open his mouth. He will go to the temple, go and say prayer and other things and come home. He would not speak to anyone about the gospel. But at the Pentecost, when he received his wage of Holy Spirit, the change in him was greatest of all. So he was most drunk at the Pentecost. And as he received the Holy Spirit, he could not contain than to open his mouth and start preaching gospel. And all were surprised to see Peter speaking gospel, preaching gospel, and everyone listened in his own language. So the mysteries of God, they do not obey the natural laws. So Peter, when he preached gospel, the message spiritual thing, then everyone listened in his own language, mean that it was the God who was conveying to them the gospel. And it surprised them, you know, that was the taste of gospel Christ Jesus gave to everyone who was, you know, most of the people over there, they were simple-minded people. And they loved Christ Jesus, but these priests were putting on the yoke over them. As people are under Pope, most of them are the good people, because the yoke is of the Pope, they cannot deny it, because their forefathers had borne that yoke. And that is in that sense, you know, that's why Jesus said, unless you deny your mother and father, you cannot follow me. That means so far you are under the domination of your parents, who do what their rabbis tell them to do, or what Pope is telling them to do. You cannot understand gospel. You cannot be his worker. Jesus was solitary. He came us to make us solitary. In Jesus, we do not follow anyone. Not even Jesus. We understand gospel and we vet everything in spirit. So if you are a person of spirit, then there's no problem for you to vet people in spirit, whether they are from India, Pakistan, Romania, Russia, any country. When they speak, you can tell them what language he is speaking, whether it is sugar-coated sermon or gospel truth. God bless.